let f of x equal 4 minus x squared, where x is greater than or equal to 0. Notice here we have what's called a domain restriction. We only want the function f of x when x is greater than or equal to 0. Let's go ahead and state this domain using interval notation. If x is greater than or equal to 0, using interval notation, we have the interval from 0 to infinity. Because the interval includes 0, we use a square bracket to the left and a parenthesis to the right. Number 1, we're asked to find the range of f of x, again, given the domain restriction. Well, if x is always greater than or equal to 0, and the function is f of x equals 4 minus x squared, the maximum value of the function f of x is 4. All other values will be less than 4, and therefore the range using inequalities would be y less than or equal to 4. Using interval notation, we have the interval from negative infinity to 4, and again the interval includes 4. We use a square bracket to the right of 4. Let's verify this graphically. Using desmos.com, we can enter domain restrictions in curly brackets as seen here. Analyzing the graph on the right, we can see the domain is x greater than or equal to 0, that's the domain restriction, and the range is y less than or equal to 4. Number 2, we're asked to determine f inverse of x. Before we determine f inverse of x, though, I'm going to go down to number 3, where it asks us to state the domain and range of f inverse of x. If we know the domain and range of f of x, then the domain and range are interchanged for the domain and range of f inverse of x, which means the domain of f inverse of x is the same as the range of f of x, which is the interval from negative infinity to 4, closed on 4, and the range of f inverse of x is the same as the domain of f of x, which is the interval from 0 to infinity, where the interval is closed on 0. This is going to be helpful when we now determine f inverse of x. To determine f inverse of x, we begin by replacing f of x with y in the original function, which gives us y equals 4 minus x squared. To find the inverse, we now interchange x and y, which gives us the equation x equals 4 minus y squared. And now we need to solve this equation for y, so we're going to add y squared to both sides and subtract x on both sides, which gives us y squared equals 4 minus x. And now we need to solve the equation for y. To solve for y, we will take the square root of both sides of the equation to undo the squaring, and then algebraically we include a plus or minus on the right. So again, we have y squared equals 4 minus x, and now we take the square root of both sides of the equation and include a plus or minus. Solving for y, we have y equals plus or minus the square root of the quantity 4 minus x. For the last step, we substitute f inverse of x for y, but before we do this, let's talk about this plus or minus. Because the output is always going to be greater than or equal to 0 based upon the range, we can drop the minus and just say we know y equals the principal or positive square root of the quantity 4 minus x, which indicates f inverse of x equals the square root of the quantity 4 minus x. So if we gave the inverse using the plus and minus, that would be incorrect, which is why it's always important to determine the domain and range of the function as well as the inverse function. Before we go, let's go ahead and check this graphically by making sure f of x and f inverse of x are symmetrical or reflections across y equals x. So going back to Desmos, let's in cell 2, let's enter y equals x. And let's go ahead and graph this using a dashed line. So I'll click on the circle and select the dashed line. And now we'll go down to cell 3 and enter our inverse function, which is y equals the square root, or principal square root, of 4 minus x. Let's use a different color. Let's use red. And notice that the original function in black and the inverse function in red are reflections across y equals x, or symmetrical across y equals x. verifying f inverse of x is correct. I hope you found this helpful.